Now is the time, Portal Master.
Hey everybody, how's it going? This is Mike with SkylanderNutts.com. I am back today to do our last two Sensei Realm walkthroughs. Now, I held off for a while because I was waiting for another Water Skylander, and we got Grave Clobber here. Now, I know he came out like a month ago, but we were also waiting for that cursed Tiki Temple, and the whole thing that got delayed, it took a little longer. So, finally, we did our unboxing. We have it all done now for wave four. So now I'm going to jump back into the game to do our final two walkthroughs. Now I'm going to start off though with the magic realm, and for that I'm going to use Master Buckshot. So I'm going to put him on the portal. Now I can tell you straight off the bat that Master Buckshot is my least favorite Skylander of the year. Now there's still a few more to come out, but he has not been one of my favorites at all. I think he's a little bit slow, he's weak, he doesn't have any really great moves, so I have a hard time playing with him. The boys, they don't actively say they don't like him, but they don't use him very much, and they don't have a, he doesn't last long when they do use him, so he's definitely on our list for possible worst Skylander of the year. Now I know some of you might really like him, so if you do, I'd love to hear it, because the one great thing about Skylanders is one person's favorite Skylander is another person's most hated Skylander, because they all play different and everyone has like a different favorite, and I think that's one of the great things about Skylanders. But we're still going to use him. He is a level 19, and he does not have all of his upgrades yet, which is very unusual for us to have him so highly leveled, but yet not any of the upgrades. Alright, so let's get into this magic realm. This is going to be a little bit more complicated than the water realm. We're going to look at our goals. We got some story goals, not too hard. We have three treasure chests, one soul gem, and a troll radio to find. And no lives lost, hopefully, although I'm not going to promise that with Buckshot, even at level 19. Defeat the enemies, that should be easy, final areas. And we're not going for the speedrun. This is one of those levels that have a speedrun for some reason. Alright, now the main thing about this level though is that it's a giant maze.
Hey Skylander, what's shaking? Me? I was just hanging out down here, minding my own business, mixing up some magical potions, when suddenly... Maybe you could stop him. Come on, it'll be easy. You just need to make your way through the maze of mystical madness without getting lost or going insane. I'll even help. Here's my first piece of advice. Pick up these magical gems and place them in nearby receptacle dealies whenever you're blocked. See? I'm already helping. Got it.
All right.
Magic Skylanders are stronger here.
So the big part about this level is it's a giant maze, and it has three different levels of these bottles that you can pick up to open and shut different areas off. So we're going to pick up the first one. It's not very hard. They show you right here. See, there's a little purplish black wall right here. It'll damage you if you try to go through it. So you have to unlock it by putting this, potion into its correct spot. See? That opens it up pretty easy right here. And they give you another one. This one's green. And there's another green wall right here. So they're showing you the different types right off the bat. And finally, there's this white one. As you can see, I can't go anywhere. Whoop, just fell off. Just like that. Well, the white ones create a path. So now that we know what to do, now we just have to know when to do it. So here's a green door that's locked to us right now. And here's our green thing, our potion, but we're not gonna use it right away. First, we got a little battle on our hands. Now here's where Buckshot's main attack is with triple arrow, at least it's triple, it might be more than that now, attack. It's not very strong. He's still doing 9 to 14 damage, and that's with the bonus of the magic realm help. These guys aren't too hard, but he also, if you can watch him hop there, he hops like a rabbit, not a goat. I don't know why goats hop, but it's really slow, and he doesn't have any dash ability or any way to get out of the way quickly. Alright, so now we're going to pick up this purple one. The cool thing is you can have more than one picked up at one time, at least one per color. So you never know when you're going to need to use them, though. Here, we need to use the green one to get through. But I picked up the purple one, just in case. Woo-hoo! Plus, I know we'll need it eventually. I also know that we have... See, we have a purple wall in front of us. We have another green wall over here. You can go back and pick them up after you put them down. Sometimes you have to do that, but I'm not going to do that right now. We got this battle here. Now, Buckshot here can do some portals, and that's kind of his main way of escaping. And now that I've got some upgrades on it, it do some damage when he comes in and out of them, I think. Also pretty helpful, if you shoot the arrows through the portals, you can see they go out of them and they continue on their path, like through a portal, which is kind of nice. You can't really, it's hard to use that to a specific advantage in killing enemies, but you know you can get some extra hits in just by having some portals around while you're shooting. Alright, so this treasure chest here is locked by a green wall, so we need green potion, which we don't have right now. And I think the one I just put down, yeah, if I pick it up, this wall is still shuts again, so I can't pick that one up. So we're gonna have to bring another green one around to later, I guess, to get that treasure chest. All right, for now, we're gonna put the purple one in. Let's see, I'm gonna go this way, if I can. You and I forget exactly where I can go. Here's another green, waiting for a green potion. Nothing down here. I guess we have to go up then. We have to find that green potion and try to somehow get it back to the first treasure chest area. But we don't have the ability yet. Maybe it's up here. I know it is up here though. And it's a little bit of a... This is how the enemies work on this level. This one, we have an enemy gate, but usually you get to a platform and there are a bunch of enemies to fight. Almost like little mini gong battles. These guys are pretty easy. My little arrows can do just enough damage to get rid of these chompy squids or whatever they are. Alright, now it gets harder though. These guys are tough, they're kind of fast. Plus we got these mini bottle beasts in the back throwing potions. I'm taking damage because I'm going to get hit from all sides. Now, he has an attack I like to use once I have some space, and that's his Y attack. He shoots this little portal out that kind of sucks enemies to me, but when I have an upgrade that when it explodes, that's the key, because it'll suck them to it and then explode on him, and that does some damage. It also does some damage if you shoot right through him. See that? That's the most damaging attack he really has, doing about 90 damage. But as you can see, I'm already half dead in this one battle, and I just can't get away from these. They just keep coming. See those bouncing orbs that the bottle beasts throw? Oh man, I am gonna die in the first battle. This is ridiculous. Level 19 and I can't survive. I survived a little bit before because I leveled up once in a while, but here I'm not leveling up. Now I'm just running, trying not to get hit by anything. so tough. I got orbs coming off the edge of the screen. I'd like to shoot some more powerful shots, but if you saw, I started taking damage because I could shoot that powerful shot. It takes a couple seconds for him to get it ready. Let's do it. Oh, nope. There's an orb coming. I got hit by that orb. He's just not very mobile. Very tough. To get away from these things. Oh, and I leveled up, so I got one last lucky level. That's not going to happen again because I'm level 20 now. So that refueled all my health. Hopefully I can make it through the rest of this level, but there are more battles like this, and they get even harder with these little mini bottle beads. So there. I ain't sure what that glowing orb does. It goes out, sometimes it brings them back. Other times it just explodes on them, which is great.
Got your goat. No, wait, I'm a goat.
All right, so I got my Imaginite chest for winning that battle. Chaos
Ball. And I got you.
All right, dump this experience, though it doesn't really matter, I guess, anymore. And here's our second chest. This one's behind a purple wall, so we're gonna have to come back with purple eventually. But now we have a green potion that maybe we can go back and get that first chest with. At least before we take it to where it's supposed to go. I'm gonna pick up this purple one again. There we go. Put the green one down.
Go, go, go!
And we get our first treasure chest. I'm pretty sure my boys didn't get any of the treasures on this level. Maybe one if they were lucky. Because they don't like backtracking. They do not like, or do not think, to go back to where they've been to try to get through another door. Now I'm gonna see if there's a green one that I put in to get through here. Somewhere over on the left, I need to place this green one down again. So the purple one's gotta go back in here. Here's a green spot. Alright, so that opens up back to this way, but also, I don't think I need to go down. This path has been opened. You see this white one right here. Now we just pick it up and put it right back down to make that curve around. We're gonna have to go that way later. Here's a purple one. Well, this one isn't attached to the door already, so that's helpful. There's a purple wall here and a purple wall there.
Get out of my way and into my car.
Alright, so I think we need to go that way, but I'm going to first come back and go this way. Somewhere on this side is a troll radio. I'm not sure. I don't think it's here, though. This is just a needless battle that I probably don't even want to get into, but now I'm in it, so. Lots of orbs here. Shoot through the portals. Hope I get some extra hits. Ever for him to kill anybody.
Get
my portals to blast him. He does do a little damage when he comes out of these portals. Takes damage though. A lot of damage when it goes in the portal. It's the best way of escaping, but everything he does is just a little bit slow. Now there was supposed to be a Valentine's Day version of Buckshot called Heartbreaker Buckshot, but it looks like he was canceled because the official Skylander site took him off their list of Imaginators sometime right before February. So my guess is that there were production problems, but I'm not at all upset because I just do not like playing with them. So I don't think, you know, having another one wouldn't have been too fun, even though usually I like playing with them a second time, getting a new set of attacks and the other path. But for him, I just don't care. Alright, so that did get us an Imaginite check.
New sorcerer weapon.
And then there's a selfie spot over there. You can see right here, there is a the outline of a bridge. So if I find, if I pick up that white thing or put it somewhere else, I might be able to create a bridge there. So I can go to the selfie spot. Now, is that important? No. Would I do that if I were you? Probably not. It just doesn't seem very worthwhile. Now it's over there. I gotta get to it again. Now, is the bridge gonna appear just because I take this off? I'm not even sure. I didn't see a place to put one over here, but maybe there was. See, I can't get in there. The bridge is there, though. So, okay, the bridge is there. I see it. So basically, I just need to not put the white one in yet to curve the other bridge. Keep the pink one in here. Now we can cross it. See, now there's a bridge. And some food, which actually is more worthwhile than the selfie is.
Goat!
All right. You see the troll radio is just over there too. See it? We'll get to that, I think, right near the end. Surprised they didn't make Buckshot have a Easter variant, because he does hop like a bunny rabbit. Okay, now we gotta find our way around. I think we use this one again. All right, basically we get back to where we were. Nothing down here. I'm assuming I'm going to need another green one, or maybe another purple one. So we have to get that other treasure chest still, and we need a purple one to do that. Alright, so now we take this green one, it opens this up again.
Oof.
Propel is in our way there. Maybe I don't want to take the green one yet. Yeah, there we go. This opens up this purple one to be taken. There's the purple blocking it. So if you put it down here, now it should be unlocked. Yep. So this is how we go around to get our second treasure chest. The last one's easy, so this is really the last hard one to get. From here, I think you just need to make it to the end. This path is open. Now, if this is a white one, this would probably change this bridge somehow. But there isn't, I don't think, a good reason to do that. Maybe there is, let's check. Here's a white one, we can see what happens. Goes away. I'm guessing it did something important, so we'll just leave it there. But here is that troll radio. Whoops, oh, I got a little anxious. Alright.
Let's do this thing. Alright, on the money. Alright.
Here we go.
And we have a winner. Hey, you want to change the channel on this troll radio? You know, you just hit me. You know, put a little bustle.
Let's see, I do believe we still need to find a soul gem. I'm trying to remember where that was now. It might be whatever that unlocked. It might be what we need for to get the soul gem. I don't think it's down there. Whoops. Us. I wish I remember where the soul gem was. I know where the last treasure chest is. Oh, I remember where the soul gem is. Okay. Yeah, we didn't miss it. We're gonna have another battle here, though. I did some damage. Got that, whatever that ball of magical energy to go right through the enemies a couple times. That's a good shot. They're one at a time, it's not so hard. It's when they're coming at you four at a time, every different angle. That's when it gets tough, especially with Buckshot here. All right, we gotta find a place to put this pink potion to unlock that area. Maybe I should not have picked it up. Bridge. Well, there's another one. Oh, I have two pink potions. Oh my. This maze can definitely drive you crazy. I've done it several times now and I still don't know exactly where I need to put everything. I only remember exactly where, like, the treasure chests are and troll radio and that kind of stuff. I definitely have missed. I have missed a purple placement area so that I can get that open over there. And now if I go down here, there's a bunch of treasure. Let's see.
I can't make heads or tails out of these numbers. Of course, I failed math. Heads or tails class, too.
Portals sometimes shoot ram or sheep projectiles. I'll take that. And I still have to go get the Sky Chi ability there in Shelmont Shores. I've not taken him through that level yet. But now he's got all the attacks he could possibly have, so hopefully I can. It'll get a little easier, hopefully, for me. Alright, well, let's take a green one. How do I open that up? Very strange. I don't remember having this specific problem before with the pink not being open on the other side. I kind of think. I don't know. It's also hard to see. If I could just move the camera around, I could tell if it was. I think it's fixed. Yeah, there we go. That must have been it. Now, is there a bridge over there I need? I don't see one. Okay. Probably gonna regret holding on to this white. This white potion, but we'll keep going. Now that we got this unlocked. I think we're gonna have another battle.
There he is! There's that potion stealing punk! Give him a little what for, Skylander!
Alright, well. That's one of our, that's our last main boss there, is that. Bottle beast. But we're not gonna go attack the bottle beast yet. We are first gonna go over here to the left. That's where the soul gem is. It's inside this door. Wow, they both fell off. That was pretty lucky. So yeah, this is where the soul gem is. This weird spinning room. You just let it spin until you get to the roof. You'll get the soul gem.
Buckshot soul gem.
The soul gem for Buckshot.
Shot.
Huh. Alright. And then we spin around again and we just get out the door. Now all we need is one last treasure chest.
They don't stand a shot of a chance.
Oh, first we gotta beat this bottle beast. Portals anywhere. But if you shoot in the portals, dude, some of them are hitting bottle beats. Portal attack might be the best way to attack, too. Every time you come out or go into one, there's that little explosion. Only after some upgrades will that happen, I think. There we go.
That ought to teach him to steal my potions. Or it would if he was still here. But hey, you saved the magic, Skylander. Nice going. And of course, you're welcome to stick around here as long as you want. Who knows? Might find some cool stuff. We're not just all bottle beasts and illusionary bridges around here, you know?
Alright, pick up our Imaginite chest.
New legs. Set complete.
Ooh. Finish the squid wizard. That's pretty cool.
Oh, yeah!
Alright, before you go down that rail, which is our last exit out of here, go in this door. Get your treasure chest. That was not hard. Alright. We now have all three of our collections. Got enough enemies. Way too slow for the speedrun. Speedrun will actually be hard, I think, on this one. Now we can grind the rail.
Grind the challenge.
Not one of the more difficult grind challenges either. There's no obstacles that you have to jump. You just have to stay on the right rail at the right time.
Level complete.
All right, so we did our 2 stars, and all I got to do is go through this again and try to figure out that maze in under 7 minutes. Just do the bare bones, not go for the treasure chests. Hopefully it won't be that long. It should be pretty easy. Definitely not going to use Buckshot though. I'm going to need a fast, strong Skylander to get through those battles quick as possible. Okay, now let's head on over to the water realm. Now, I think the water realm is a little easier. The boys again didn't explore it a lot, and it's weird because it's kind of right in front of you. I don't think it's too hard to find the treasure chest in that one. From what I remember. Let's switch on over to Grave Clobber.
A watery grave awaits.
Ready for some high speed adventure at Skylanders Raceway?
Sensei Water Realm discovered.
Here we are at the last one, Sensei Water Realm.
Sensei Water Realm.
Now our story goals are pretty simple. Open the temple gate and close the water vortex. Our collections are the same. Three chests, one troll radio, and one soul gem. And then there's no speed run on this one, so we should get all 3 stars.
Pop quiz, Skylander. Did you know that all water in Skylands originates from this very spot? Although I guess that's not much of a quiz since I just gave you the answer. Anyway, did you also know that a mysterious black hole has popped up here and threatens to drain all that water forever? Luckily, though, we have a contingency plan to deal with something like this. But it involves you getting to the top of this temple while I go get something from the Council of Gilman Elders. Will you help me? Because we kind of need water.
Got it.
All right.
Water Skylanders are stronger here.
Now, the boys played this in co-op, and it is not very fun in co-op to have to make all these jumps. You screw up and fall off. And then you're kind of that dude all over again, especially with two of them. Now, Grave Clobber has this water fountain attack, I guess. I like using it. You just have to sit here and let it kill the enemies pretty easy. So, not too bad. That opens this, and now you have to make these more jumps. As a single player goes, that's not too bad, but like I said, the boys definitely had trouble doing it at the same time. Now, right above me, you can see there's a treasure chest, so we have to do that to go this way. So as soon as we can move these up again somehow, we'll be able to go back and get that treasure chest. Now, he also has a Y attack, is this belly flop with a resulting shockwave that is a water wave that goes across the screen. Pretty cool, not too bad, but I like setting up my water fountains first. These water fountains have also been upgraded. Upgraded with some extra power. Now, when in doubt, though, use his fist, because he is Grave Clobber. I mean, he's got powerful punches. Just look at this guy in comparison to Buckshot. His water fountains are doing 100 to 150 damage. The punches are quick, and they do 82 damage each, unlike the 14 to 15 from the bow arrows. And he's only level 8. He's not even close to 20. Way different character. He's still kind of slow, like Buckshot, but like for some damage. I think he's got more health too.
Back to the grave with you. Although I don't know if you originally came from the grave.
All right, so you need to play this little mini game and fix the fountain. Spin around to see it. Flash, spin the other one around. You're supposed to kill these little water. And that'll open the gate. So before we go up there, actually, these guys are going to come down to us. So let me just throw a fountain up here. Deal with those guys. And then we'll come down here. Here is the next little. I guess it's a water ball. You make it bigger, you spin the left trigger here, and our little floating islands are gonna move. Now we can go over there and get our treasure chest. Alright. However, keep coming down from that point. There you see our soul gem. Kingpin Soul Gem. We've been waiting a long time to get his Soul Gem. Now we can finally give him all of his moves. We can preview him.
Kingpin. Woohoo!
Everybody should have Kingpin. He's pretty cool. Alright. I think that's it. Yeah, Grave Clobber is certainly not going to win any speed awards either, but it's alright. He makes up for it with power. Alright, there's our first treasure chest. Before we go up these stairs all the way, we should go over this side. Yeah, we're gonna have another battle on our hands though. But there's our troll radio waiting for us. The longer you hold down the B button, you can watch. Well, actually not the longer, but you can move the fountain to wherever you want it with your stick while you have the B button held down. These eels are, I guess, out of range. There we go. Pulling right on top of them. Make short work of some of those enemies. They don't last forever, but they last long enough, I think. Alright, here's our troll radio. Let's get this out of the way. There we go. No. Lots of these little balls to have to pump up, I guess, to make these bridges move. Our treasure chest over there. Oh, we gotta get to it somehow. My fountain do all the work on him here. Look at that. Fountain makes short work of the tube shark.
Level up.
Belly flops. They don't use it very much.
I shall spend all eternity savoring.
And look at that. Those set of enemies gave us a treasure chest. New Imaginite pieces. Oh, that's weird. Dragonfly wings. Connor will probably like those. Now, I don't think... Alright, we're going to go down here. But you really probably don't have to. If you already got the troll radio, I don't think doing this is important. What we do need to do before I do that, maybe, is open up this ball. I I guess this is like a key of some sort. Well, yeah. So I don't know if that's going to help, but when we fall down here, we can't get back up anymore. That's a problem. It's an annoying problem, but you get some treasure. Oh, there is a treasure chest here, so I was wrong. You do have to do this. Yep, the second treasure chest is here. Well, in that case, should you have missed the troll radio before, the only way out of here is to drop down. So we're going to drop down right here, and that's where the troll radio is, but we already got that. Now, the only problem is we have to make all these jumps again. And in some cases, we'll have to move. Like, yeah, as soon as we get up here, we're going to have to move these platforms down again. And then we're going to have to go and do what I just did and move those platforms back up again if we want to get to that other side. Which must be how we get over to that treasure chest. Actually, we have to do it just because we gotta get through this gate. These water gates are controlled by the fountain puzzles, and you see a fountain puzzle over there, so we definitely have to go over to the other side. And from there, or maybe it's when we get back over here, we'll have to go get that treasure chest. The good thing about the treasure chest on this level is you pretty much see them, except for that second one, I think. That second one is the one I forgot about. Pretty much see them, and you just gotta figure out, well, how do I get to it? With the magic realm that we just were in, the problem is you couldn't see them a lot of the times. You had to just pick a direction to go and hope there was something over there. He does, he gets up from his belly flop pretty quick. If you look at me, hit that Y button over and over again. That wave that he uses will knock down, knock back most enemies. So it's a way to keep them off their feet.
Back to the grave with you! Although I don't know if you originally came from the grave.
Alright, so now we gotta spin these again. Just spin them until you see the glowing. And switch rings, spin again. One last time. Alright. Oh, look. I don't know at what point, it must have been after we did that, a bridge has appeared to a bridge. A bridge of floating platforms has appeared to the last treasure chest. They definitely weren't here before. Also, some bonus treasure here. I don't know why. Selfie spot. Pretty waterfalls that you can't do anything with.
See? There's more to me than just clobbering.
All right. And that should be all of our collection goals. Got some more enemies to defeat, though.
the spirits of the undead to show you my ability.
We can now purchase his soul gem attack.
How convenient.
Hold after any punch, hold X to launch a lariat attack. Okay. Punch. Whoa. That's weird. Let's see how it works. This like automatically creates three fountains. Pretty cool soul gem attack. That did some damage. Since I already had those fountains leveled up, having three of them, if they don't all get destroyed, we'll do a bunch of damage. Now he will do a little dash punch when you hold it down. And you see there, I destroyed all of them. I think, man. You can change the direction that he goes in after they pop up though. So if you hold it and then move your stick in a different direction, you won't destroy the fountain. And therefore, it'll do more damage for you. Plus, you can add fountains to it with that attack. Have even more fountains around. I'm a fan of the fountains. I like the fountains. I chose the fountain upgrade path just because I like using them instead of punching. I can use them when I'm not around. Like if I need to go explore, like go over here. Or there's an energy ball up here I can get, but as I'm getting it, I can let the town do some work. There we go. That's pretty fun.
Check this out. Our legendary anti-black hole harpoon cannon. Just need your mind magic to fire it up. Come on.
Alright, so that's pretty much it. We found everything on this level. Beat a bunch of enemies. Here's our final Imaginite chest.
New chest.
Lantern torso. And now we use the harpoon to shoot into the vortex.
Oh my codfish, you did it! Now say goodbye to this black hole. Have you ever said goodbye to a black hole before? Me neither. Nice working with you, Skylander. And speaking for pretty much all aquatic creatures, thank you for saving our water.
Level complete.
All right, there we go. And wow, I just got enough enemies. Wow, that's weird. I don't know if that's always the case, but 100 out of 100, no extras. Alright guys, there you have it. That was the last two Sensei Realms. I've walked through now the Magic Realm, which was not really a walkthrough. I just kind of stumbled through it. But I found all the treasure chests and we got all the stars. And then we walked through the Water Realm and got all the treasure chests and stars there as well. If you want to do the speed run on the magic realm, just remember to use a fast and strong character, and you might take you a couple times to learn the exact path to go the quickest through the maze. I have not done that yet. I've spent some time stumbling just looking for things, so I don't think it'll be too hard, but it might take a couple tries. That'll do it. Come back next week when I'm going to have a walkthrough of the Cursed Tiki Temple. Have you guys played that yet? Have you gotten stuck? It didn't seem too hard when the boys played it, but next week I will show you where everything is and how to get all the stars. So until then, check out our other videos, subscribe, like this video, follow us on Pinterest and Facebook and Twitter, and we will see you soon.